second video of Revit Architecture. In this video, we are going to learn how to place your door and window in your walls. In last video, we are discussed about how to draw your wall, and in this video, we are going to discuss about door and window. First thing is that, like, if you want to place your door here, your window is here. For that, first go to your floor. Your floor is here. Just click on ground floor and then go to architectures, and you can see here door and window. First you click on your door, and then you can see many size of doors is in default here. If you want to edit your if you want to edit your door, just go to edit type and then edit your door. First you make your duplicate. You can write down door 1, give your name of door 1, and then you can see the thickness is here. If you want to make your thickness more, you can just click here thickness and write down how much you want. Like your height is 7 feet, it's enough. And this one is your trim projection axis. This one is your like exterior, and like you can see here the thickness of door is here. This thickness is called trim projection axis. If you want to edit this one, you can edit this one, but I'm going to edit only width. Width is here, your width is 3 feet, and this one is correct, you know well. So 3 feet and 3 feet is the width of this door, and 7 feet the height of this door. Just okay. And you can just place your, suppose you want your door here, just click here. You want door here, you can just click here, right click, cancel. Two times when you right click, cancel, you can edit this one. This position of door is wrong, so if you want to edit your door position, just click here. And then if you want inner wall door, just click here. And opening of door, this door is in the direction, this one is not correct, so you can just click here and you can send in your right direction. Same is here, and you can see this one is your door placement. And like if you want to see in 3D, but I want first to place a window also, so you can just click on window. You can see many window sizes there. If you want to make your own window duplicate also, so go to edit type. First you go to edit and duplicate, and you can see this one is your window first. Okay, and then you can give your height. Height is 4 feet, that's correct. And second one is your sill height. Sill height is the height from your plinth level to window height. This one is 3 feet, this is correct. And then width is 3 feet. I want to increase this width 4 feet. Just enter and then go to OK. By this method you can edit. And then if you want to place here your window, place here, you can edit this window. If you want to edit this window here, just edit this window. And then if you want to see in 3D, just go to view and then click on 3D view. You can see your door is placed here, and this door is placed here, and like your window is here, and your second window is here. If you want to like change your window or door place, suppose you want like gapping from here to here is not 3 feet. If you want to, it's 6 feet. You can write down 6 feet. You can see this one is edit from here to here 6 feet. Same here. If you want to 6 feet, just click 6 feet, and you can see this one is edit. You can like change your wall and door and everything positions. Like suppose you want from here to here is not 6 feet, and like 8 feet 11 inch. If you want to 9 feet, just enter. Just like you can change your like positions of this one. And your next topic is in this video is floor. How to create your floor. For floor, first go to ground floor and then draw your floor. How to draw your floor? You can see in architecture part, this one is your floor. Just click on floor and then draw your floor shape. If you can take your line and polyline and other shapes also. So I'm going to take a rectangle, just place rectangle like that, and you can create your floor. You can see your building is this one. Your building is this one. If you want to edit your floor size, like from here to here, you want to edit this one, just go to ground floor and then select your floor and then click on edit boundary. And suppose you want this one from here. For that, you can offset just like AutoCAD. Just click on offset, and how much you want, it depend on you. Suppose I want 5 feet offset from here to here. Just you can click 5 feet. In this side also, you can click 5 feet. And then delete this wall. Sorry, this boundary, and this one is also. And then meet this one, you can use here trim and extend corners. Just click here, and then just click on first one, and then also press a shift key, and then click on second one. Shift plus first and second. Shift press and first and second, then shift plus and first and second. Yes. You can see your floor is correct here. You can click shift button and mouse middle button. This one is your span, and then you can rotate in anywhere directions. In next video, we are going to discuss about how to create your floor materials, wall materials, and other materials. How can you create materials? We are going to discuss about material in next video. So I hope you like this video, and please subscribe my channel and give me support. If you give me support, then I will produce next and next videos for many software sites, ETABS, 3ds Max, and Photoshop, and Tekla also. So please give me support, like and comment. If you have any questions, if you want to ask something, you can comment. I will definitely reply you. Thank you so much for watching this video.